We're happy to be here with our town board members, Sue Berlin, Mark Cuthbertson, Mark Mayoka, and we're delighted that we have Steve McGloin, our Director of Traffic Safety, with us, and Brad Cusco, Traffic Engineer, in his office. And they will be doing a presentation on this new system. Larkfield Road, we know, is the busiest road in the town, and the town has 800 miles of road. We did a traffic survey, and we found that roughly 27,000 cars a day go past and through Larkfield Road. As the road got more heavily used, motorists began experiencing extensive delays because of the 13 independently functioning traffic signals. What we did was, this project then was designed to get the traffic travel speed up to the speed limit, 40 miles an hour between Jericho Turnpike and Clay Pits Road, and then 30 miles an hour in all of the sections. The cost of this project, to synchronize these lights and to have them efficient for motorists, was approximately $1.8 million. Now, 80% of that came from the federal government, 15% came from the state, and the town contributed around $90,000 to complete this project. The work began in October of 2011, and the system right now is fully operational. It included the installing of energy-efficient LED traffic signal indications, including pedestrian signals with countdown timers. The project also brought pedestrian crosswalks and handicap ramps up to current American Disability Act standards. The main part of the project, however, involved installing the computerized coordinated signal system at the 13 town control signals on Larkfield Road. You know, people have said it's much better than it was. The traffic now moves. There aren't the delays. And now we took our busiest road in the town and we made it more pedestrian and more motorist friendly. So we're delighted that we're able to share this today and share a demonstration following comments by our members of the town board. Thank you. Mark Cuthbertson, council.
Thank you, Mr. Supervisor, and thank you for all of your hard work on this issue. This is, you've heard of the good news and the bad news. This is a good news and good news situation. The good news is that traffic will move more quickly on Larkfield Road, and we've seen it already, the benefit of this shared spending plan between the Fed, state, and town. The good news also is that those cameras that you see above all those lights are not giving tickets. Everyone thinks where there's a camera, there's tickets. Now, at the intersection of Jericho Turnpike, there are tickets, but for the rest, and some of us have gotten those tickets, but for the rest of Larkfield Road, those cameras are designed to help synchronize all of these lights and make Larkfield Road move more efficiently. So it is indeed very good news. And it is a part of an overall comprehensive plan in our town to improve traffic. In the Horizons 2020 plan, among the things that we talked to residents about and solicited their opinions and concerns and frustrations certainly was traffic. And as we look to infill development or approve other developments, we have to address the issue of traffic. This is one way of addressing the issue of traffic. And we've seen other things that have helped make traffic better, certainly on 110, whether it's in Hale Site, the two roundabouts that are functioning now, the widening of Route 110 at the LIE, the widening of the service roads, widening of the overpass at Pine Lawn, Wellwood Avenue there. All of those things are a part of a comprehensive plan that are designed to make traffic move more quickly and better in the town of Huntington. And just a last note on the positive things you see on Larkfield Road, I mean, not just those lights, but I think in the redesign of the Larkfield, the comments from the traffic department were that there shouldn't be an in and out of that big catering hall anymore. When that project was approved for a beautiful new redevelopment, the Larkfield now, cars can only come in, and the traffic's going to move better on Larkfield as a result of that. So thank you, Supervisor Petrone, Mr. McGloin, for the hard work, which is just a spoke in the wheel of an overall plan. Councilwoman Berland.
I want to thank you first for all being here this morning. This is a great example of how different layers of government can work together. You have local government, federal government, state government, all working for the goal, which is to really bring new technology to our town. We are always trying to be on the cutting edge of technology. And when we have these systems now that can synchronize all these lights, make traffic flow much better, it's much better for the environment, the emissions go down when the cars are not idling, and most importantly is it's more safe for pedestrians. And that's really something that we're all concerned about. We want the traffic to flow, we want people to get to where they have to go, but we want our pedestrians safe as well. So this really is a win-win for everybody, and we welcome you to drive on Larkfield and enjoy the trip. Councilman Mayoka.
I'm Councilman Mark Mayoka. Councilman Cook was unable to make it today. He had a previous commitment. I want to thank Steve McLaurin, our Director of Traffic Safety, and Brad Cusco, our Traffic Engineer, who've been working on this for the past year and a half to make this a reality. I understand the system is called the NASTEC system. It has been used in New York State, and it's been used at the county level. So it's a very sophisticated system and allows us to really focus on making the traffic flow at the speed limit, and making it safer for the residents. We've had a lot of positive progress on Round Swamp Road, which a system has just been implemented. It had a tremendous impact on the traffic accidents. I believe we're working on Wolf Hill Road, and soon I hope that I think Mr. McGloin and the supervisor and my staff will work on Woodbury Road, which has had a number of fatalities and accidents over the years. And I'm in the process of going forward with the slowdown campaign and to drive safe. And this type of new technology will allow us to drive slower at the speed limits and make it safer for the residents. So I think it's a great program, and it's the beginning of what we're going to roll out. And as has been mentioned, it's part of the 2020 Horizons Plan. It's part of our rollout, and it's one of the many steps that are going to be taking place.
Thank you. As you can see, we're concerned with the traffic as our residents are concerned throughout the town. And these are the new technologies that we're employing in order to stay with it in terms of traffic. We know it's going to be there. People are driving cars, they're driving more cars. And here's an opportunity now where we can hopefully combat some of the concerns and make things better. And we thank you again, Traffic Safety, for all of your work. And at this point, we'll call on you, Steve, and Brad to do a presentation and an assimilation of how the system works. Thank you.
This map represents an overall picture of the town and the signals on the town that we're currently implementing or have implemented. If you zoom in to a section, it'll give you a more detailed picture of what's going on. So this represents the traffic signals in the middle section of Larkfield Road. And the arrows represent what the signal is actually doing, whether it's green, yellow, or red by direction. If you zoom into a signal even more, then you can see exactly what's happening in a detailed look. You can see if there's cars at a signal which represent the squares, and if the pedestrian signal is active, the hand would be green, then you know exactly what's happening.
In this black cabinet, what you're looking at is actually a controller, all the equipment that's out at the intersections. The system is going to give us the ability to is become more responsive when there's a problem out on any of the signals that are controlled. We can actually look at the signal. We can see any kind of alarms or any problems that are going on and alert the technician to cut down on the troubleshooting time that a technician out in the field would have to take to diagnose a problem.
You know, not only does this allow us to pick up cars for making the signals work better, we get a real-time view of what's actually happening there if we have to make changes. These rectangular boxes represent the detection zones for vehicles. So when a vehicle would cross over one of those areas, it would change, it would put a call in for the signal. What happens is it would change to a white color when a vehicle would go over it.
In there, it's actually going to set up a timing sequence. So it's not necessarily going to change immediately, but it's going to put it into that sequence where it knows there's a vehicle there and it has to now change and you know, and it'll eventually change. If we don't pick that car up, then it's going to stay green on Larkfield Road.
So now here's a car traveling and it turns white, so I picked up the car. See, now here's a car approaching a side street at Eastport Shopping Center, and it picks the car up, and
there's an overall timing plan for the whole corridor. So we, you know, so it gets kind of complicated that, you know, we want to keep the cars flowing on Larkfield Road, but we also want to make sure we service the side streets. So there's timing plans that Brad has done to accommodate that. Knowing that the vehicle is there sets it into the proper timing to accommodate the side streets, and as well as keep Larkfield Road going as best we can. Extending out the green time when there's four or five cars there, that helps get everybody off the side street onto Larkfield Road.
So basically the side street will get a green time of 6 seconds initially. So if a car gets to the side street, puts in a pull, it'll get 6 seconds of green time. Every car that passes over the loop, it extends it 2 more seconds, up to a maximum of time.
And now you can go down to Larkfield Road and go on a side street and see how long it takes you to cross. Thanks so much. Any other questions?